put it down.
Of course. Tau Adair, isn't it?
I'm not here to talk.
What a shame.
Receiving.
I'm here, Admiral.
No, you're not here. That is a problem. We were counting on you to stop an Imperial strike team on Ord Trossi. They came in fast and overwhelmed ground security. Half their planetary defense grid is gone.
I'm sorry to hear that, Admiral, but this lead took priority.
Priority? Are you telling me your little antique hunt was more important to the Jedi than protecting Republic citizens?
Stopping Malgus will keep the Republic safe. We needed something to push our investigation forward. And I think I found it.
Well, I hope the price we paid was worth it. Rava, out.
Get me the commander. It's urgent.
Look at that. Perfect timing.
Good. You're here. Didn't want to put this in anyone's hands but yours. Ugh, sorry. Some greasy Sith really didn't want me to have that.
Are you all right? I can take you to the med bay.
Don't worry about me. What you've got in your hands is way more important. That belonged to Darth Null. Took us ages to find it, but it was worth it.
I'm sorry I wasn't there to help you.
You are helping. Why do you think I came straight here? Arn and the old man have been breaking their backs, looking for patterns in what we know about Darth Null, hoping to find another fortress. They must have read every report on Null at least 20 times apiece. They finally narrowed it down to a few places that seemed like good candidates. We split up and started looking. I was the lucky winner, the one who knows the least about this stuff, but I'm hoping you can help me fix that.
I'm fortunate to have so many knowledgeable specialists on just about any subject. My science expert, Dr. Ogorob, may be able to help.
A science expert? Not what I was expecting to hear, but I'm open to anything at this point.
Oh, don't let him hear you say that. Not unless you want to volunteer for one of Doc's many new research projects.
Let's see if he can help us, but be ready for questions. He's going to want to know every detail about the place where you found this.
Come on. How bad can he be?
Not now, Sahar.
Just try. I know you have it in you.
That's not what your precious Jedi said.
It's what I'm saying.
Found my way without your sorcery. Heta cut my slave collar with this. She gave me a choice. Die or fight back. I fought and I excelled, Sahar. The day I became a Mandalorian, I knew I found my home.
I hoped you would find success. You always had fire.
I had little choice. Some earn what they have. Some are given everything.
And some lose it all.
You dare speak to me about suffering?
Even the best armor has flaws. Spaces between plates of Beskar steel where blood can be drawn. The events of Runuk have shown me our flaws. I planned for Shae Vizsla to find us. She did. I challenged her and won. Basque Sun and his Darmanda have taken their credits and scuttled back to whatever cave spawned them. All as expected. What was unplanned? The gap in our armor. Is the fear we engineered in our enemy. They brought an entire fleet to rescue poor Shae. Such cowardice in those who call themselves Mandalorians. It cost us what we built on Runuk. We bled, but we gained something far more important. Sahar, can you come up here? This one brought me something taken from the clutches of Darth Malgus. Something so powerful, both the Sith and the Jedi race across the galaxy to claim it. With Sahar's help, we can unlock its secrets.
I told you, Heta, we shouldn't do this. It's not safe.
You're right. It's never safe to change a galaxy. Never easy to fight corruption and hypocrisy. But your brother said you would face anything to restore balance. Each of you will gather the resources needed to make my vision a reality. You will have your assignments, but none will know the whole plan except myself and Sahar. At long last, we will take back what is ours.
So, I heard you ran into Sahar. Is she all right? Can't believe she's gotten herself mixed up in all that Mandalorian business.
There was so much chaos and confusion on Runuk, and very little understanding. I couldn't do anything to convince Sahar to return. I know this must be hard for you.
I just wish I could tell her that Elam wasn't the end, that she'll always be welcome back with open arms. You know, I barely even remember her mentioning a brother on Ossus. Now he's got her turning her back on us.
Over here! I do believe I found something. But first, you must tell me more about this containment device you encountered. What did it look like? How did it work?
I didn't get a chance to look closely at it or anything. I just know it was some kind of trap and that relic was in it.
Can you tell us about what you found? The longer I'm near the relic, the more unsettled, I feel. Whatever this was, it inflicted unthinkable suffering upon others.
Your perception is spot on, as usual. From the results, I can say with certainty that what you found is the remnant of a lightsaber. But there is more to the story.
What else did you find?
A very interesting clue. My equipment also found microscopic fragments of the lightsaber's power source. By all indications, the crystal used to construct the weapon originated in the Adika system.
That's where Osis is. Jedi get crystals from the Adika system to build their lightsabers. We have for hundreds of years.
So why did Darth Nol have a lightsaber that was built like a Jedi's?
A very pertinent question.
Well, she was helping the Emperor control people through the Force, right? I'll bet she used those crystals in some horrible machine that hunted down Jedi and turned them into children of the Emperor.
What else could she have built with them?
In theory, the possibilities are limitless from all she seemed to know. Someone who does not shy away from knowledge, no matter its source, in order to create, to expand their awareness. It is admirable.
Null was controlling people's minds. Let's not pin any medals on her just yet. What do you think about talking to Malgus again? You've got something up your sleeve you didn't have last time.
We're getting closer to understanding how Darth Nol worked, but we still don't know what Malgus is trying to imitate. Not for sure, anyway. Maybe if I tell him about what we know, he'll open up, whether he means to or not.
I do not envy you having to attempt any sort of communication with that ill-tempered brute.
Thank you both for your help on this.
It has been my pleasure.
No problem. I'm going to let the old man know what we found. He and Arn will be dying to hear everything.
The chat you had with Dr. Ogura paints a better picture of what Malgus may have been up to. Darth Nol's work on mind control says a lot, but combining Sith and Jedi toys? That's big news. Malgus following in the footsteps of someone with Jedi connections is a plot twist I wasn't expecting. Never mind Heta Cole getting her hands on Darth Nol's holocron.
Has Malgus been behaving himself?
Haven't seen any security alerts since the last time you were here. He can't use mind tricks on the droids, and no one gets in without our say-so. You could say he's been on his best behavior, if he weren't so uncooperative.
What we learned about Darth Nol's Jedi influence does give us something to go on, though admittedly not much.
Heads up. Looks like we have a special guest.
Tell these droids to get out of my way. I need to speak to Malgus.
They answer only to the Supreme Chancellor and cannot be overridden, Shae.
Some higher-up is all sweaty about my past contracts with Malgus. They've got no understanding of how those things work.
One of those contracts was destroying the defense grid on Coruscant during an Imperial invasion.
I was there to do a job. I did it and moved on. You should understand that. You and I have an understanding, but I owe no loyalty to the Republic or to the Empire, Malgus included.
Perhaps, but permission to interrogate the prisoner is restricted to a select few.
I'm going to find out if he's working with Heta, with or without permission.
That's why I'm here. We all need to know more about his plan.
Don't you get it? With the holocron, Heta is part of that plan, willing or not.
You weren't interested in the holocron when we ran into Sahar.
I wasn't, but I won't let Heta use whatever's on there to hurt my people. Things have changed between us since Runic, but that doesn't matter right now. So, what's it gonna be?
I can handle Malgus. I've done it before.
And you've got nothing. Use the same tactics, get the same results. Think about it. I'm the only one here who knows him. I get how he thinks, how he twists everything around, what's really important to him. I can make this happen.
Doesn't change the fact that Shae isn't on the VIP list.
Then put me on comms.
Comms? To listen in?
More than that, Shae can give advice during my questioning.
Malgus had a few bad habits when I worked with him. I'm betting they're still there. If you listen to me, we can trip him up.
Risky. But the situation calls for it.
At least we'll be in full control. If anything seems wrong, we can shut it down.
The moment you cease being useful, you're cut off. Is that clear? She doesn't move from this spot.
Against Malgus. He fears nothing. You keep talking about putting an end to what he wants, and we'll get nowhere. Make him think you understand. That's the key to getting anything out of him.
If you explain to me what you hope to accomplish, maybe I can help you. Maybe there's another way to finish what you started. A way that others will accept.
Few minds can comprehend my vision.
That is true. You and I have a unique perspective.
Perhaps that is why they parade you in front of me.
Good start. Try asking him something.
I was surprised to learn that Heta Cole was part of your plan.
She wasn't. My designs are much greater than her petty civil war. The Mandalorians are fractured, a broken people. They struggle to decide who they are. An endless cycle of waste and fodder. Useless.
Big talk from inside that cell.
Mandalorian history is nothing but slaughter and bloodshed. They know how to follow orders without question.
Or fight for a purpose.
Slippery Chakaris. Okay, maybe Heta wasn't part of his plan, but something sure as hell changed.
You can't conquer the galaxy without an army.
When I am through, one will rise from the ashes. I will tear apart the corrupt systems that allow weakness to infect the galaxy. I will stop the rot. I will burn down all of their failing legacies and see who embraces the flame.
More of his mystical Osic. What about the holocron? Does Heta have something she can use against my people?
Who whispers in your ear?
This is between you and me, Malgus.
It is too late.
Your thoughts are plain to me, Mandalore the Avenger. Your rage consumes you.
There was a battle, and your prey slipped through your fingers.
Your people are divided, while Heta Cole gathers her army.
You are right to come begging for answers. Heta will destroy you.
Where is she? Dinila Hutun, answer me!
The past looms over us all. A shadow of unchanging history. There are fools who believe they can outrun the shadow. Without a flame to chase it away, it will consume them. They are doomed to repeat the same failures. None who have stood by my side have understood this. The only one who could have is my enemy. A shame that you and I must remain that way.
Nothing lasts forever.
Request.
What's going on? Is everything all right?
Yes. For the moment, I have been summoned by the three. What they had to say has left me disquieted. Meet me at these coordinates on Voss, and I will explain in greater detail.
I sent you to look into the origins of one of Darth Null's relics. I haven't heard any updates.
What I found... It is best if I show you in person. I will await your arrival.
Voss. Well, at least it's nice this time of year.
We have enough mysteries to contend with without getting the Voss involved. They're not exactly known for being straightforward. Sana Ray sounded unlike herself. I do hope whatever she has to tell you isn't too troubling.